Hi, I'm Jeremy Tesh with EFI. Here's a high-level demo of FireXF production. FireXF for production, as the name suggests, is a fiery digital front end designed for production printing. Whether it's banners, point of sale items, posters, it has built-in production tools and capabilities that mean you don't need to step outside the FireXF workflow to efficiently prepare jobs for print. This saves valuable time and brings consistency to your print production, regardless of which software your jobs are prepared in and which printers you work with. The software is modular and scalable, so you can add more printers or options as your needs grow. Some typical tasks needed to make jobs ready for print production are nesting jobs to save substrate costs, step and repeat, piling, late stage color edits, cut path creation, and more. Let's take a quick look at how easy and intuitive these tools are within FireXF. First, Fire uses the Command Workstation client, which is a free download you can install anywhere, and it connects up to 10 servers, so you always have your production printers available and coordinated. I have a number of demo printers associated with this server, but the typical amount is 1 to 4. That varies based on production demands and so on. FireXF Production gets you started with one printer, and because FireXF is scalable and modular, you can add printers and options to that over time as you grow. Fire supports over 800 different printers. If you outgrow the server, you can easily spin up a new one and join it to the same Command Workstation client. In Command Workstation, we present a clean, modern interface, and it's completely flexible. So if you're preparing jobs in a very hands-on visual way, we have Job Explorer, full screen tool for that. Or if you have Prepress pushing jobs into the server for you, or workflows built up with lots of automation, you can just work in Job Center and concentrate on job management, getting the right job out to the right printer. And everything I need is integrated in Fiery, whether it's layout, cut integration, color tools, spot color control, and so on. I'm going to grab this group of jobs to create a nest. A nest is just bringing jobs together to minimize media use. Let's take a closer look by opening in Job Editor. So what's going on here is files are being rotated and the spatial placement optimized to minimize media use down the roll. This works for rigid and roll type media. So the benefit of this is it's super fast and it's flexible, so it can respond to quick changes at time of print. So for example, I'm currently set up to print on a 50-inch roll. If I run out of that media, I can quickly change this to a 64-inch roll. But you'll see I'm wasting all this space on the right, but I can quickly fix that by just updating the layout. And now you can see it's re-optimized for this new condition without having to go upstream and redo all of this in prepress. Huge benefit and gives you all kinds of flexibility. Let me show you another example, this time with step and repeat, which is a great way to do multiple copies. And the first thing I'm going to do is go to the layout, step and repeat, turn it on, and I want 10 copies. Let's just fill that last row, make use of the media. Now we have multiple copies. If I want to integrate my cutting device and speed up finishing, I can quickly do that by going to the finishing tab and selecting, for example, our Summa cutting device. And the registration marks are placed. And when this job is finished printing, this cut file will go directly to the cutting device. And remember, any layout I do here also follows along with the cut file. So not only is it fast and adaptable, it's completely integrated. And Fiery supports around 1,200 different cutting devices. Let's do a few more things just to finalize this job. So first of all, if this step and repeat is working for me and I want to repeat it, I can capture this as a preset. And that's the first step to automation. There's many areas in Fiery where you can capture things as presets and easily apply them to different jobs or other workflows. And here we're going to change one of those presets and just change the front-end color management for this job. Another example of being flexible and having a late stage color change. But I can also take the automation further. So I did about 5 or 6 different things to prepare this job. If this is something I'm going to do over and over again, it's a good idea to capture it as a workflow. And Fiery allows you to create as many workflows as you need. There's no limit. And one of the best ways to do that is just capture it at the job prep stage. Once we have workflows established, we can use them to provide consistency and shorten the amount of time it takes to get files to our printer. Let's launch Server Manager and show you just a few final things. So Server Manager is where all the global settings for Fiery reside. And one thing you'll find here are the RIP core settings. And this really refers to the interpretation and processing of complex files like EPS, PostScript, and of course PDF files. So in Fiery, we have 3 types of RIP cores. We have the legacy Adobe PostScript core. We also have the Adobe PDF Print Engine. And this is the industry standard print engine for interpreting PDF files. and it's fairly common, although not all rips have a PDF print engine. It keeps the files in a native PDF format, so you're able to process confidently all the complex files created in Adobe Creative Cloud. So what's unique to FireE is the extension of the Adobe PDF print engine called FastRip. FastRip was built as a partnership with Adobe, and basically it uses the Adobe PDF print engine for the interpretation of the file, and then uses our technology for the rendering or the building of the pixels. So you can maintain the file integrity with the Adobe PDF print engine, but then speed things up 5 to 10 times faster. It's available in all versions of FireE. One more thing before we finish. Inside this printer is the workflow we created earlier in Job Explorer. I can also create copies of that workflow or create completely new ones here. And this is where some automation can be established by capturing routine tasks in unlimited amount of workflows. Then when my workflows are established, I can start feeding jobs into the client or via hot folders, really accelerating my productivity.